This talk is going to be about a method for solving differential equations. Actually, it's more a method of reducing one differential equation to other possibly simpler differential equations. So the idea is like this. You have a differential equation, okay? It means it's f is an expression involving x, the independent variable, y, the dependent variable, and the derivatives of y with respect to x, okay? And it's just saying some expression in these is zero. Now, what does it mean when I say it's equal to zero? It has to be equal to zero for every for all things in the domain. So for every x in the domain, when you plug this in, you'll get zero, right? Though if the domain has some boundary points, you ignore the boundary points as far as the derivative calculation is concerned. So I guess interior of the domain. But the point is it's true everywhere, okay? Or everywhere except the boundary, okay? Now the idea of factorization is you start with this. You first see if f can be factored, this whole expression. So remember, if your equation is written as something equals something, you have to bring everything to one side first, okay? Then try to factor that whole expression as a product of two expressions, okay? And then, so g and h, and now you're trying to solve g times h is 0, okay? Mm-hmm. Now, be careful, I'm going to slip a bit here. So you know that the product of two things is 0 means one of them is 0, right? Mm-hmm. So either this is 0 or this is 0.
Yeah.
So we have to find all solutions for this. Find all solutions for this. So find general solution for this. General solution for this. And then the general solution for f is just a solution, something to solve for f if it's either a solution for g or a solution for h. Mm-hmm. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. What did I miss here? This is a very minor thing I missed out on. Okay.
When both of them are 0.
Well, both of them are 0 will be included in the union, right? Uh-huh. It'll be in both of them, in fact. So the union there may be some intersection. What I'm asking is there something which is not a solution for G and not a solution for H, but could still be a solution for F?
No.
Well, it could happen. Sorry. I mean, this is a very minor point. But the thing is that it could happen that there is a solution which... So remember, what this thing is that for every x in the domain of f, this is 0, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, it could happen that there's a solution which for every x, the f is 0. But it's not true that for every x, g is 0 or for every x, h is 0. Rather, for some x, g is 0 and for some x, h is 0. Okay, so it's a solution which satisfies f everywhere, but it satisfies g on part of the domain and satisfies h on the remaining part of the domain. Okay, so you could have that kind of solution. That won't come up in the solution for G individually or the solution for H individually. But we are actually it's still almost true. So I'll write these mixed solutions, which are kind of weird. Locally, they don't matter. But if you are doing global piecing together, they kind of do matter. Okay, so mixed solutions. We'll see a little bit more about mixed solutions in a while. Okay, now this is good. Because there are certain kinds of equations we can definitively solve using this. But let me first do one example which doesn't involve mixed solutions. So I'll also check what happens there. There's a couple of remarks I want to make. I'll make them once you sort of made some headway through the example. Okay. So first example. So here's a differential equation for you. Maybe you've seen this before. Minus 3yy prime plus 2y square is 0. So it's already in the form where everything's on one side. That's good. Now can you factor this for me?
Y prime minus y times y prime minus 2y.
Okay, so now we want to first find the solutions for these individually. Okay, so y prime equals y. What are the solutions for these?
E to the x.
That's one solution. What's the general solution?
E to the x plus c.
The plus c is in the exponent, so we just bring that down. So we get c1 e to the x. Right? Yeah?
Mm.
Okay, and what's the other solution? Other thing, y prime equals 2y gives what? 2 times e to the
2x.
So we have here, so we have two solution families here. One solution family is multiples of e to the x. So each value of c1 will give a particular solution for this and hence also for the original equation. Okay. Then you have another family which is multiples of e to the 2x. Each value of c2 will give one solution for this equation and hence also for the original equation. Okay. Now my question is, are there any mixed solutions? Can you have a situation where for part of the domain you have y prime equals y and for the rest of the domain you have y prime equals 2y. So it sort of switches between the two solutions. Can you have that?
Yes.
When can you have that? Well, if they switch, then at the point where they switch, you'll have to have y and 2y are equal, right?
I'll be 0.
So y will be 0. But if y is 0, in either of these solutions, that will force c1 to be 0. Right? Because this is never zero.
Mm-hmm.
And C2 will also be zero, which means that the whole function is the zero function. But the zero function is already included as a pure solution. Okay? So there's no mixed solutions. No new mixed solutions. Okay? I mean, the only mixed solution is the one where y equals zero, but that's already included as a pure solution in either of the pieces. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so what is the general solution? Well, now I use different letters C1 and C2 here. That's just to indicate they're not related, but actually I could have used the same letter. The point is, so how many free parameters are there in the general solution? What would you say?
Free?
I mean, how many parameters are you need to describe this general solution to this differential equation?
What?
Hmm?
What?
One, not two. So even though you have a C1 and a C2, so the solution space is in some sense one dimensional. What that means is that there's only one parameter. It's like this gives you a line's worth of solutions, right? A real line's worth of solutions. This gives you another real line's worth of solutions. The total number of solutions is like a union of two lines, okay? So the general solution is a union of two solution families. So y is c e to the x, c and r, and y is c e to the 2x, c and r. And this c need not be the same as that c, it doesn't really matter. The point is that it's just a one parameter thing, right? It's like a union of two lines is still considered one dimensional, okay? It's not two dimensional. So the number of free parameters is one, okay? So that's good. Now in the next video, we'll do an example where you actually do have mixed solutions. And that's going to be a fascinating thing with piecewise definitions, etc. Okay.